everyone, April here. I'm so happy to be getting over COVID and be back with you all with a new video. At the end of every month, I try to do a Power Platform Rewind where I recap the news for the previous month. I missed that last week because I was sick, but I figured it's better late than never. So let's dive right in. It's time to rewind. The first major news that we had last month was Copresence and Power Automate. Many of us have waited a long time to see this day. If you've ever tried to collaborate and work with one of your colleagues on debugging or creating a flow in Power Automate in the past, then you know how big of a pain that it can be. Now with the availability of Copresence and Power Automate, we're able to collaborate and work on a flow as a team. So we're going to be able to see, as you're seeing in the screenshot here, the presence of other team members that are currently in that flow and have it open. So very similar to what we see when we're working with a Word doc or an Excel spreadsheet, whatever it might be already. And also we can make changes and work on the flow at the same time. It's going to have built-in conflict resolution, so it's going to be able to identify if there's any conflicts in the flow. And we can do things like discard our changes, save a copy, or overwrite. So this should go a long way to helping us be able to more easily build flows in Power Automate and collaborate on building those. Pretty excited about this next one too, being able to generate PowerFX formulas from examples. This is what we call programming by example. So maybe you've heard stuff in the news about GitHub Copilot. This is kind of a similar technology that we now have access to inside of Power Apps with PowerFX. With this, we're able to give an example of the data that we might want to return, and then it will produce the necessary PowerFX formula that we would need to make that happen. So the GIF that you're seeing kind of walks through an example of how this would work. So maybe I want to change this date field here to show only the month. I can select the date field, click Show Ideas, and just remove the text to show May. Then it's going to create and generate the formula for me. And I can kind of map a little bit of examples there of other fields in there and kind of follow the pattern there. And it generates the formula, or the PowerFX expressions that I need to be able to make that happen. This is insanely powerful. You see how we have kind of a complex PowerFX formula that's generated by that. So now I don't have to worry about going to the Power Users forum, doing a Bing or Google search to be able to figure out how to extract that month text from a label. I just tell it, here's what I wanted to do, what I wanted to return as, show it a few examples, and it produces a formula for me. This is a huge step forward in making Power Apps more of a no-code story. I've said all the time that Power Apps is a low-code technology because we are expected to know some kind of code with these expressions that we build in PowerFX. But features like this that we're seeing really goes a long way to make it even easier to get into Power Platform and into building Power Apps without having to have an extensive background in Excel formulas and all of that. This functionality is really new, so at the moment, this really only works with labels inside of a gallery, hence the example that you're seeing here. And it ideally works best with dates and strings. So this isn't going to be the end-all be-all for everything at the moment, but I can definitely see them expanding this functionality to accommodate for more scenarios inside of our Canvas apps. Keeping on track with the PowerFX news, we now have a new PowerFX formula column inside of Dataverse. This is another one of those super powerful new features. It's giving us a way to express business logic on top of existing columns. And we can even reference columns from other tables. With these columns, all the calculations are done at the Dataverse level. And these results can be seen in multiple places, anywhere that Dataverse interacts. So this could be Dataverse, Dataverse for Teams, Power Apps, Canvas apps, model-driven apps, Power Automate, you name it. Just like that programming by example, there is a big caveat here since this is new and in public preview. Right now, it is limited to use with inside of Dataverse for Teams, but there are plans to bring it to the Maker portal soon. Let's switch over to some Power Automate news. As always, every month, Natalie has been putting out and releasing all of the new connectors that we have for Power Automate as part of the Independent Publisher Connector Program. As you can see, this program is growing fast, and we have so many amazing community members that are contributing their samples. A few that caught my eye that were released in the past couple months here were the Spotify connector by Daniel Laskowitz, and the Discord connector, which I believe Daniel and Michael worked on together, and the Yelp, which I believe Ahmad worked on. I can see a lot of cool use cases for those connectors, and I can't wait to get my hands on them. And you can see the full list of all the great connectors that the community has created here by going to github.com/Microsoft/Power Platform Connectors. The next big piece of news is all about model-driven apps. We now have app side panes in public preview. These app side panes can switch by clicking on a different tab in here that will replace the content, and of course we can collapse and condense those. They support navigating in place as well as navigating with the back button. Next up, we have a great new sample that is out there and available to use for an employee FAQ bot. This sample has a Power Virtual Agent bot that shows you how you can take an input from an employee and do escalations. It shows integration with inside of Microsoft Teams so you can escalate with a one-on-one chat. And the other cool thing about this sample and this template is it includes a Power App. This can be embedded as part of the solution where it can show answers to frequently asked questions. You can check out this cool new sample by going to aka.ms/PVA employee FAQ. Now this next one is for the Power Apps devs. So many times when we're working in Fusion teams and creating those Fusion scenarios and we want to maybe extend our applications, there are key pieces of information that we might need from a Power App to be able to do things like connecting through an SDK, service endpoints, developer tools, and all that. With a new option in the gear in the Maker portal, you'll find a link for developer resources now. This is going to give you key information you need, like environment, unique names and IDs, links to the API, and discovery endpoints. It just makes getting the information you need to be able to properly extend the platform that much easier. I think I mentioned last month, or maybe in one of my previous videos, because I did do a video on this one, we have these new DLP policy options available to us. One of those being able to take a connector and allow or deny specific actions within that connector. And another new functionality where we can do endpoint filtering. Now this stuff was announced and released a little while ago, but the big news here is it's now available in public preview worldwide in all regions. If you want to learn more about how this action-based filtering, the endpoint filtering works, I'll put a link to my video that I did on that a while back so you can check that out. Next piece of news is all around Power Platform Administration. So there's certain maintenance windows that we have when pushing out updates to the Power Platform. Now with this new functionality, we're able to control when we want our maintenance window to be. There's going to be a new setting that we have in the Power Platform admin portal where we can override that and put our preferences for our maintenance windows. Now obviously this is going to apply for scheduled updates and not unexpected outages. The next big piece of news is all about controlling access to your applications on the Power Platform. Conditional access for applications is now in public preview. Now, traditionally, conditional access for Power Apps was an all or nothing thing. You had to apply this setting and have it applied to all of the applications you build or nothing. Now we're able to apply this on the individual application layer. So if we have certain applications that might need conditional access but not others, we can control that now. If you want a really good walkthrough of what exactly this means, there's a PowerCat video that was released recently that walks you through exactly how this works and goes into more detail, which I'll put a link to in the video notes. And last piece of news, if you haven't looked at solutions on the Power Platform lately, then you might want to look again because they have a brand new look. Now in public preview, we have an updated Solution Explorer experience. This makes it so much easier to be able to see what exactly is inside of a solution and to manage all of the pieces. It's a great new experience in public preview and will eventually be pushed out to be the default experience for solutions, so definitely check it out. Well, that's all that I had for you for the September 2021 edition of Power Platform Rewind. If you want to get caught up on some of the other news and announcements that were released in previous months, check out some of my other episodes of Power Platform Rewind. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.